rotate and even bump to the left, or if you're a right-handed golfer, first, and then have the rest of the body follow along behind you. So that's the problem. There has to be a weight shift. So part of that weight shift, your body needs to know that it could balance here on one leg, but mostly on the left. Coordinate that belt buckle to the left. Okay. Now, if it seems like your upper body kind of goes with you, okay, try not to. Okay. That's more of a stability issue. Both directions, okay? That could be a red flag. That could be sort of lacking down drastic, but. Okay, so I'm gonna turn it over to Mike. You can bring your chairs back, and we'll just set up.
So now I'll give you a little better pattern on the path here. So we'll go to address and slowly swing it back. A little bit of back swing is pretty doggone good. Okay, fantastic right there. Gonna watch the movement from the top. Now I'm going to kind of show you this from above. I hope you can see it okay. Let's put a target line on the ground. You see how the club head is already on the outside of the ball, let's say. And we'll kind of run it through impact. Foot before impact. Their club face matched the path perfectly, okay? And the side profile of the draw probably looks like this. You see the difference in distance?
Let's go with number two.
So now, as a quick example, I'm going to kind of use these three balls I've drawn on here, but I'm going to use them a different way.
Right.
We'll put the green light on the